nerd dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 99 in our series, Create a RubyGem, Nerd Dice. And in this video, we're going to be updating our changelog and backporting our changes that we're noting in the changelog into the appropriate stable versions of our branch before we release them. So I was considering at the end of the last video doing the changelog updates combined with the releases of these gem versions, and I think that would have been too much going on for one video, but I think it does make sense to couple writing the changelog with looking at the changes we've made and getting them into the branches that where they need to go. So we've got our issue here. If we go and look at our change log here. So the we don't have anything later than the last change we made was 10/23. So we'll kind of note the differences that we've made since then. So there is one, if we go into our code and look at our master branch, so 10, October 3rd, 2021 is when we made our last changes and did the release for version 0.4.0. So that would be essentially everything since then. That we don't need to note the bump version commits in the log there, or in the change log. But I guess what we'll have here is we this just looks like the changes related to updating the bundle when we upgraded to Ruby 3.1 and 3.2. So those are changes that will be noted in every version that has a GitHub Actions build here. So if we take a look at our branches, version 1 does not have a GitHub Actions item, so that kind of wouldn't be noted that we added those versions to the build. Version 2 does have it, so essentially 0.2.1, 0.3.1, 0.4.1 will have the changelog item. And we're gonna, I guess, start with the versions here that we're gonna have. So version 0.5.0 beyond 2023, 02/23. I mean, at least Eastern time. It's the 24th now if you're dealing with UTC, but it is what it is. And then we'd have version 0.4.1. And each of these will have a added, changed, fixed associated with them. Now we've got 0.3.1. And 0.1.2. So first change is added actions. I don't know why I started in 0.3. So changed. Remove Ruby 2.7 from GitHub actions. Helps if I spell remove correctly. So the add, I guess we'll start by doing everything that's going in 0.5, and then we'll copy down the ones that apply to the other gems. So changed a look at our commits on master here. We've got added 3.1, added 3.2, removed 2.7. A fix, remove hard-coded link from README. Guidelines to the project. Refactor RuboCop. Config. And then let's see here, we fixed a cognitive complexity. Code smell inconvenience methods. drop support for Ruby 2.7. We've already got there. Update the bundle and then fix. So none of these are going to stay on master. Everything is going to go on 0.5.0 here. So let's take a look now at 0.4.1. So we'll actually, let's get this changelog into a markdown editor. So that I can switch branches here. So it's all fine. All right, so now that we're doing the editing here, I can just git stash save. All right, so we're git stash save. Now we're going to go into git checkout. See how our branches are named. So we're going to check out version 0.4. Let's see our sorry, but your princess is in another castle version of our changelog. We don't really need to care about the security on this. All right, so let's start here. Ruby 3.1 and 3.2 adding to the actions. And given that Ruby 2.7 is getting dropped, I'm okay with doing both of those on the 4.1 branch there. So a little git cherry pick. Already backported that one, so don't need to worry about that. That's the reason why that's not there. So let's try cherry picking the next one. That seems to have worked. The README change, I think we can take a look at that commit. Yeah, because we don't want to hard code to master for that, so that's fine to cherry pick. So assign all of these. Make sure that our version is correct. That needs to be 0. I'll do that at the end. Back to our set of commits here. Security policy, I do not need to bring into this branch. We only really need to care about the master branch for that. I'm not going to do the same thing that I did with the change log where I kind of, sorry, but your princess is in another castle on it, but that is, let's see here, contributing guidelines. Nobody really needs that on the branch either. RuboCop refactor, we will pull in. Let's see, back on our update changelog here. So we're doing this, the security policy and contributing guidelines are not being added in. The that change is being there. I'm not bumping the minimum on that. We did take the RuboCop refactoring. The code smell fix we will take. Drop support for Ruby 2.7, we are not adding to the 0.4 branch. And then update the bundle and obviously update the gem signing certificate we do need. So in this case, we're going to do a we'll note updated the bundle and stays, and then these all get included. So back on our commit history, let's see here. Where were we? So update bundle. I think this one, even with all of the changes, will be okay. If not, I might just need to, we'll find out whether it builds or whether RuboCop will give me trouble there or not. And then the gem signing certificate one. So we'll attempt to cherry pick this one. Back to our commit history. Try this one out. Good. Let's see what happened to our gemfile.lock here. Yes. So in this case, we want right now. Keep that, and then that version of secure random. Happens on our genpile.lock. I think we're okay there. Before we commit this, we need to All right, that's all working. And RuboCop's working. So git status, git add. Lock. And I did have that one set to be signed. Git cherry pick continue. Existing message is fine. I think we're done with this one. We just need to bump the version and then redo a bundle install. Sure that our gemfile.lock now reflects 0.4.1. It does. Our spec. RuboCop. Do git add, git commit, pause and write my message here. All right, I've got the commit message for this one. Try to push this to that branch. Hopefully the build we kick off will succeed. Take a look at our changelog version here, version 0.4.1. That's looking good. Now we're going to take a look at 0.3. So we will git checkout 0.3 stable. This one we've also already added 3.1 to the GitHub actions for. So we need to cherry pick this one. Gemfile and Gemfile.lock here. RSpec and rake. We're fine with. This one's already got 0.3.1 in its version, which is probably what I should have done previously. But I think we're good there. And then our other conflict is in the gem file itself. And we'll take the incoming change for that one. Git add. Well, make sure we can. Didn't save it. Unable to find spec satisfying rake 13. Git add gemfile.lock, git cherry pick, continue. So far, so good. Ruby 3.1 to Ruby 3.2. We'll see if we can cherry pick this one or not. Seems to have succeeded. Take a look at the README here. That looks like it succeeded. So back to our changelog. The update to the README is going to remain in 0.3. Removal of Ruby 2.7 from GitHub Actions has happened. RuboCop refactoring. We'll see how that one goes. At least provisionally, put those both in there. in the changed section. So now back to our commits. So the security policy we skip, contributing guidelines we skip. We'll see if we can get rubocop.yaml one. See. Give it a shot, and if it doesn't work, we can just check out the same version that's in 0.4. Give this one a shot. Looks like it succeeded. We'll take it. Let's check on our 0.4 build. That looks like it succeeded. Let's take a look at our branch and make sure all of our commits are verified. Oops, update bundle for the gem did not get signed. We'll rebase to get that done. Come back to that. All right, so our next item here, this is I guess it would only be a subset of what we have on 0. Fix the code smell, that's not going to apply. Update the bundle. This is going to be, so we're going to do a, yeah, this is going to have a lot of difference here. So we're going to check out the gemspec. Check out the gem file potentially. Status, get diff cached. That's not going to, need to bump that back down to 2.7. But otherwise, I think we're good here. So let's, in our gem spec, and we'll do the same thing with the gem file. Didn't change in that commit. So back in our gem spec, we need to make sure that we bump this back down to 2.7. Let's take a look back at our gem spec, get status, get diff cached. So now we've only got the dependency changes. Now we're going to do a bundle update. And then we're going to run RuboCop. And then we're going to correct RuboCop. So, because we've got vastly different tests here, it's necessary to do it this way. So git status rspec spec. We're good. Git commit sign. We're just gonna take the commit message we had for this. I'll have a note here. So, should be able to close the commit message. What happened here? Only committed the gemspec. So git status and git commit amend. Now our working tree is clean. Back to our items here. Commits, update the bundle, update the gem signing certificate we absolutely need. Sense. Install. No changes. Our version is set to 0.3.1. I think we're good to push this one. back to our changelog, updating hard-coded link from readme. Update expired gem signing certificate. Oh, that's the wrong version. 0.3.1. All right, now we're down to 0.2. So git checkout version 0.2 stable, git log. This one had Ruby 3.1 added as well. Let's just take a look at our preview. 0.2.1 is what we're at now. Have to modify that at the end. Like we did on the version 0.4 branch. So let's take a look at what we've got on 0.3 stable, which is a subset of what we've got there. Although we probably want to cherry pick better. Why is that? We'll have to do some rebasing on that one as well. All right, so we'll just go back to master and cherry pick from master. All right, so 3.2, we can cherry pick. Status, our gem file and gemfile.lock. Accept incoming change. Incoming change. Bundle install. Bundle update rake. Bundle install. Status. So we are okay there. The hard-coded link, we'll see if that one can be supported. Looks like it can. Me. Yep, that worked. So, yeah, I guess you can kind of get the idea of why I'm end-of-lifing some of these earlier versions of the gem. This is kind of a tedious process to go through and backport all these changes. Let's see here. security policy, contributing guidelines, not applicable. The RuboCop config, we'll see how it goes. Far so good. Code smell does not get picked. Job support for Ruby 2.7 does not get picked. And then this one, we're going to check out the gemspec. To reinstitute 2.7 here. Status. Add bundle update. Same message. Oh, not same message. Well, we'll amend it. Close this and realize that RuboCop is probably failing. And it is autocorrect. RSpec RuboCop. Sign, no, edit. All right, so now we are, that was the update bundle commit. And the last one is the update signing certificate. Status. All right. Now we need to update our version here to 0.2.1. Bundle install. Write the commit message by hijacking it from the version 0.4. branch. I didn't update the certificate in 0.4, but we'll modify that in a second when we cherry pickers need to have good memories. All right, so I think we're good there. Let's make sure that our git status, git push. While I'm thinking of it, I need to check back out. Let's deal with 0.1 and then we'll go from there. So 0.1. Case going to we don't have a GitHub actions at all. We'll modify the bundle later on. The README, let's see what the README has. No, I can cherry pick that. So git that goes there. The security policy contributing aren't applicable. RuboCop, we can try it. We'll see how it goes. We'll just check out okay. We'll deal with that when we update, when we do the bundle update portion there. Now we're going to continue on. We need RuboCop code smell is not applicable. Support for Ruby 2.7 is not applicable. We will update the bundle. We're just going to do something similar here where we check out the version that's in 0.4. Let's see here. I'm going to do the same thing with the gem file. Bundle update. Corrected. RuboCop is passing. RSpec is passing. Sign it. Going to be essentially the same. Commit message here. Actually, it's going to be more like the ones for the other versions. Finally, we need to cherry pick the main reason why we're doing this release to begin with. Of my optical drive. All right, so it's looking about right. Our version needs to become 0.1.2. Bundle install. Copy the version we had in 0.2. And then the message. One, two, buckle my shoe. All right, we'll close that. Push. All right, so now it's a good thing I didn't try to do this all in one video with the releases. We're going to take a look at how our actions have done. It's the version 4, version 3, version 2. Let's go back to version 4 here. Version 0.4 stable, git diff master. Yep. So we need to cherry pick that commit back to master here. Security, git cherry pick, continue. I should have done no edit, but now we're here. Git status, git log. All right, so find the on version 0.4, the one we didn't sign. So we're going to git rebase interactive against that one. Git rebase I. We'll have three of these, and they're all going to be edit. And then the gem signing certificate will be second here. So I should be able to now in this. Git commit amend no edit. Git rebase continue. Successfully rebased. Now I should be able to git push. Let me just git diff origin. Just the certificate that we fixed. So git push force. Take a look at version 3. That one, we have to go back to this and rebase against it. Four, three, two, one. Control H here, replace pick with E. And this is going to be more of the probably a command that I could execute there. And I probably even did it on an earlier video. push, force it. Oh, I'm still in a detached head. Now I've successfully rebased. Just check the everything's verified on 3, everything's verified on 4. We are missing verifications on 2. Interactive rebase. Successfully rebased. And back to 1. And gotta rebase against that. I didn't check out version 1. We will change these all to edit. Don't worry, it'll change to 0.1.2. So now we've got 0.1 all verified. It has the signing certificate. Version 2 all verified. It has the signing certificate. Version 3 all verified, signing certificate. And version 4 all verified, signing certificate. So now we can go back to master. And double check that our oh, please tell me I didn't lose my change log. I might have lost my changelog. if I just go back to the issue. And, oh, thank you. Okay, so we still have the version that we wanted. So I've got to now go back and make sure that everything is here. I'm just going to pause and double check this. I know this video is very long as it is, and then we'll get this to master. All right, so I believe I'm happy with my changelog. 0.5, 0.4.1 has what we need. 0.3.1, 0.2.1 essentially has the same changes as 0.3 in terms of changelog stuff, and then 0.1.2. So what we'll do now is take that value and we will git checkout B and then we'll just paste this into the changelog. This helps provide the diff of what we're expecting here. I think we're good. Git status, git add, commit, sign. Write my commit message for this. All right, I've got my commit message here. Push to the branch. Double check our builds when we all of our patch version branches worked. We're gonna open a pull request here for this one into master. We will allow that to finish. Since it's just a changelog change, I'm going to check out master merge, delete the local branch. Ready to, all right, make sure that our final, all right, we're good. Push to master. Delete that branch. Note that this was resolved by number 55. Now, that was quite the set of stuff there. We will close this out, and then in our next video, we'll actually do the releases of the five, build and release the five gems. We'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching this stateless codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding. And don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.